But as we know, this can prove to be one of the loneliest times of the year for way too many in our community. Charities do work tirelessly to change that, and today many provided free lunches to brighten the day of the lonely and the less fortunate. Amanda Hart went along to share some stories and some laughs.
It's a little hard to feel lonely when you're surrounded by this.
Wonderful. I'm so happy. That's the best day I ever had for a long, long time.
Our charities have been busier than Santa's helpers, cooking up a festive feast to feed thousands of those less fortunate.
Just to let them know that there's people around that really care about them, and events like this just give people hope.
It takes the sting out of Christmas for someone like Joe. He's got nowhere else to go.
I look upon the mobby as the Clayton's family, the family you got when you haven't got your own family.
Santa often turns up, and so do his reindeer. Some charities have had so many volunteers like Robert, who's been serving food for 18 years, or 15-year-old Felix.
Yeah, it's good just to see these people smiling, having a good time, and I found a new friend here.
That they've had to turn volunteers away. But they won't turn away the needy. They're seeing more people fall on hard times.
Can't give as much as they did a few years ago, so they're very apprehensive about the future. So we then get with a double whammy with more people coming and individuals being able to give us less help.
So of course one of the best parts about today is of course the magical food gets served up. It's a sure lot better than what I could produce here. We've got Marianne. Tell us what's on your plate here.
I have got turkey here, I have got mixed Fiji with cauliflower, potato, and I've got stuffing. And the best thing about it, it's all for free and I enjoy the company, the people and the music.
Is it better than what could come out of your kitchen?
Definitely is. Safe cooking.
Santa, eat your heart out. Amanda Hart, 10 News.